Hey guys, I've got a little tutorial, get ready with me kind of video, and yeah, I guess that's pretty much it. I've always done these with like a voice dub over, and so I thought it'd be cool to just do it live, but not live, and I'm gonna be slamming my coffee intermittently. I swear I'd be dead without this stuff. To get started, whenever I do my makeup, I always put on a moisturizer. I'm just going to put on my Hope in a Jar. It just really makes it easy for your foundation to cling on to. I'm going to try not to edit this. I really don't edit a whole lot otherwise. And I'm going to keep my glasses close because I've been trying to... I just dropped my beauty blender. I've been trying to... learn to do my shadow. I don't know if there's any other far-sighted people out there, but I've been trying to do my my shadow with one of my eyes looks crazy bigger than the other one. I've been trying to do my shadow with my glasses because I find myself struggling with shadow application and blending out of anything. I think everybody always struggles with something when they're doing their makeup or whatever, you know, whether it's concealer, contouring. Contouring's a bitch. But anyhow, so that seems to be my biggest difficulty, and a lot of it, I believe, is because I'm really, really farsighted, and now I'm nearsighted. My eyes are getting worse. I've totally taken in the corner panel of my door and hit my aunt's mailbox, which is like a three-generational mailbox, the other day. So I think I honestly probably need to go back into the eye doctor and get another prescription because my eyes have been terrible, but... using my glasses it's a really hard thing to kind of figure out, but it's been helping. So, lotion on, and then I'm going to take, this is kind of a technique I kind of want to share, because it's really been getting me some really good results. I'm going to shut my phone off, too. So, whenever you use... a primer. I really like Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer. I think it's really good. They're not the best ingredients. It's like putting a layer of silicone on your skin, which, you know, isn't the greatest thing to do, but it's going to get your makeup to stay all effing day. And so, you know, if you're getting married, summer in Wisconsin is so humid and nasty, and I'm a really sweaty, gross person. So if I don't use something thicker or matte or have like a base layer, it comes off. So I really find a lot of luck with this, and it doesn't mess with my skin a whole lot. Give me a second. I'm going to play some tunage while I do this. I don't know how anybody else is, but I am a music junkie. Fun fact, I play the piano, guitar, and saxophone. So I'm going to take my face brush, expert face brush from Real Techniques, and just dip in, and I like to put stuff on my hand so it warms it up and makes it a little more, it melts it a little better into the skin. And I always focus on my T-zone. This really seems to seal it into my pores instead of just applying with my hands. And then I just take a sweep everywhere. But yeah, no, I'm using my Mac, my camcorder. We bought this like HD camcorder for our wedding. And, you know, just to have with the kids around. And it's not been the greatest, and it's kind of a bitch. Extra staying powder, my Naked Beauty Balm. I honestly hate this shit, and I just want to use it. And I don't think it matches my skin. Well, maybe it does. But I'm going to take the same brush. And this is all just going to keep your makeup on. And beauty balms, you know, I mean... there's so many different types out there. My favorite is the Estee Lauder Acne one because it has coverage. It's not just like a moisturizer, primer, sunscreen in one. It actually has coverage. And I always get right along my hairline as well, so there's no lines to pull it down. More than anything, too, you know, I mean, I'm building layers, but at the same time, I'm also doing this... To make my skin look more flawless. My erase paste. I love this stuff. Bobbi Brown makes a corrector as well, but you get a lot more product in here than you do with hers, and I like how emollient and moisturizing it is. And basically what correctors, under eye correctors do, and I have to bring mine up to this side because I've got issues with pigmentation here too. And I'll let that sit on for a second. But basically, I love art. I'm totally into art, photography, all of it. I used to do acrylic paintings when I was a kid. And it's just a color wheel concept. If you have purpleness under here or blueness under here, I used to use yellow concealers, but I really found like they made me look chalky and dry. It just didn't look right. This peach salmon color is just perfect for getting rid of. I mean, it's almost hard to. I'm shaky from how much caffeine I've had today. But it's really, really peachy. Almost you can tell more so without light. But it's just canceling out purple with orange, which are opposites on the color wheel. Or purple and orange and blue and yellow. So, and you can actually, there's videos on how to make your own correctors. Now I'm using a Dr. Jart's liquid contour. And you can find your natural cheekbone by, you know, pressing down. But I've got such strong cheekbones that I don't go overboard with my contour and I just put my head down. I can see them right there. I just go like that. And I am in love with this stuff. I got a sample from Sephora. They had this big, like, you know, even if you bought, like, one tiny thing, you could get, like, 10 samples. And I had a bunch of, like, VIB points that I used. And I got this sample of this, like, trio of their contouring product. This is really hard for me to do this way, so I'm going to do it like this. And I'm going to use my beauty blender. And I'm actually going to go over with a bronzer as well. I don't like a heavy contour, but I think you can't do a contour wrong if you're going to do it. So you need to be diligent about that. And I'm still letting that corrector sit on. Good old Grateful Dead. Just blend that shit. And this stuff is really, really silky. Sorry, my nose ring does that and I hate it. But it's a lot easier to take care of than those stud ones. It's a really, like, silky, wet to dry formula almost, but it's not, like, chalky at all. People would think I'm stupid for using this, but this is my favorite brush for contouring. My e.l.f. complexion brush, I've had it for 5 years or something. They're $3. And, I recently switched up my method for, you can't even really see because I'm right in the light, but I switched up my method for cleaning my brushes to a clarifying shampoo from Redken that I use on my hair if I've got too much product buildup, and a combination of Schwarzkopf Fiber Force and Moisture Kick leave-in conditioner. I'll wash it in the shampoo with hot water to open up the cuticle on my real hair brushes, then I'll rinse it out in a cold water, and then I'll dip it in that and kind of, you know, just run it around however you clean your brushes. But this is so hard for me to do one. And then I always pull down because I don't want a stripe. Nobody wants, that just doesn't look good. There should be definition, but there shouldn't be a stripe. And I pull down. And when you're doing any powders or anything like that on your face, after you've done all your work with your foundation and such, and I always go under my jaw, it's like an instant losing 5 pounds. Don't go heavy. Don't use a ton of pressure. Otherwise, you're going to be, unless you have really oily, see, this is so hard for me to do. It's like doing the thing. So I'm just going to go over here. More than anything, I'm just blending. I'm adding a tiny bit of the bronzer. And then I'm going to go under my chin. Some people do their temples, but I've got such a long face that I actually like to do this more often lately. Just totally kind of go all over the top of my hairline to shorten my face a little bit. I don't, you know, I almost feel like sometimes I can't find a bronzer deep enough because I've got such olive skin. And then I always go right down my nose. I'm a bronzaholic, not gonna lie. This is the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil. It smells like a dream. I can't believe I haven't hit pan on it. I use it every day. I love it. And then I'm gonna take my fingers. I'm really trying to go as quick as I can. Usually if I'm not, you know, if I'm not talking, you know, I can do my makeup pretty quick. But I also have to try to keep this witty and funny and not be a stale potato chip. But your finger, the texture on your fingers for as far as concealer goes and under eye correctors is so similar to the texture under your eyes and the thickness of it. And the warmth of it is like perfect. And they say you're always supposed to use your ring fingers, which I find to be correct for me. And then I'm going to go over. I love this bag. It got dirty, but it came with my Wayne Goss set. It's my favorite makeup bag. A tiny bit of the Estee Lauder Double Wear. This is so hard for me to do my camera. And then I do it. This is my pattern. Not a huge country fan, but we've had a lot of losses in our family. A lot of young, way too young losses. I'm just going to use my beauty blender because I already did the other stuff. And this is such a, honestly, a challenging product to work with, I think. Because it's double wear. I want to post a video and make a video. I haven't done yet, but this is my number one on my waterproof list. I'll swim with this on and it won't go anywhere. But anyhow, yeah. I love this song because it really just strikes a chord. We lost my sister-in-law at 26, 3 weeks before my daughter was born in 2013. And then my aunts are much more my best friends and sisters. Mom had me young, and I've just been so blessed in that way. We lost her 46, I believe, and lost my cousin, who's younger than I am, at 25 this January, so it's, I don't know, it's almost healing to listen to music that kind of makes you stop and take, I don't know, I can't even explain it. It's a grief thing, and it helps. The only way that I have, one of the only ways that help me with my grief is music by far. And then I'm taking my Brow Invocate. Actually, first, enough about that stuff. I can't find my primer, my Eden primer potion. I still have this kit. I bought the Vice 3 palette at the same time that I bought. Oh, shit. That's fun. That looks right. That looks really appropriate. I'm glad my kids have no idea what I'm talking about. This is the anti-aging one, which I've actually had a sample of before or bought. And I don't really... I like the original a little better. And if you want more staying power on your concealer, put this shit underneath it and it'll stay. And I've actually, I don't know if you're supposed to or not, but if I've had, like, my sister's wedding when I was, my sister's wedding was June 29th, and my daughter was born June 30th the next day. And I was very, without being graphic, I was halfway to progression, and her wedding was 45 minutes away. And so I used the primer potion on my face because it was so sweaty and I was having contractions. Nothing, I was in regular labor and being a total dumbass, but. So what I did just now too is take my Too Faced Brow 1B highlight. This is something I'm really liking lately. Is laying down an opaque light shadow or whatever, that Eden version of the primer potion does that for me. And it just makes the pigments and the colors pop on your face. And then I'm going to do my brows now. I'll just use a pencil. I'm not crazy about pencils, but oh well. This is the Brow Wiz in medium brown. From I can't do it like that. I'm gonna put my mirror right here. Because I can't. I'm a brow freak. I'll never get him the way I want him to be, but I can't. So what you smudge it in. Go with your natural hair pattern, go with the grain, so to speak, but smudge it in. So it stays. I hate my eyebrows. They're really thick and they get really long, but they, whoa. And then this spoolie at the end is really nice for blending. What the hell was I talking about? I swear to God. Kids do that too. You just don't even know what you're talking about anymore. When you smudge in, it almost stains the area. I overdid that. I way overdid that. But I need to. You can't see. I can't do it there. I totally fucked my brow up. I'm gonna use my mirror over here. Try to fix this. That's actually lovable. And you really, honestly, your goal is to fill in. You don't want to, like, make a brow you don't have. And you want the ends to be, the tails of the brow to be what you're... If you're going to go dark or accentuate any area, that's the area you don't want to go dark. And I'm going to extend a little bit more here today. But these spoolies really help get a good blend. Might have to go dramatic on an eye look today because my brows are a little dramatic. Somebody said the other day on Instagram, like, the brows are sisters, not twins. But, I mean, I want them to be the exact same. I mean, I don't want to look... I'm sorry, but I think Kim Kardashian looks like a big ball of plastic. I think she's beautiful, but I don't think any of it's... I don't think any of it's real. Her eyebrows have gotten better over the years, but forever her eyebrows look so like just like she cut them off of something and put them on her face. I really need to pluck my eyebrows too badly. Seriously, these spoolies are awesome at blending and getting your, like, telling your hair where to go. I still feel like this is a little too strong. And I'll show you something in a second that kind of also helps too. I use a wax every time, all the time. Like the Sex Panther perfume. Works 75% of the time, all the time. People probably get really sick of that joke from me. Like, I love to tell the joke with my husband, like, every time we have a hot dog. Same. It's been a while since I've had a hot sausage in me, which is so disgusting. I'm such a dork. If you don't know me, one thing to take is that I'm a giant effing dork. But the wax... really makes them go where you want them to go. I'm actually kind of pleased. You get a little more precision. You get a little more precision, precision with a pencil, but it's really hard not to do them. And that I'm not liking. One of those is way thicker on the bottom than the other. I can't have them look too different. You get a lot more precision with a pencil, but you have to use a light hand, which is especially hard for me after I've had a pot of coffee and I'm working on my next one as we speak. Which I really shouldn't do. Obviously, like, not. Oh my god. I'm not having luck with my brows today! I'm sorry, I can't handle shitty eyebrows. I can't. It's like, if I have to leave my house, I'm not the gal that's like, lip gloss and mascara. No, I want perfect skin and eyebrows. That's all I care about. I don't need mascara. I don't need, even I'll skip my under eye concealer, which for years I couldn't do. This one, there's a problem right there. A scar right there that always needs to be filled in. I'll live with it. All right, 25 minutes. This is really quick. So for eyeshadow, I'm gonna take nougat from my semi-sweet chocolate bar. Shit. It's a really pigmented formula and it smells like chocolate still. I'm not gonna use my glasses. Actually, I am. Let's see how I can pull this off. No, I can't. I can't so hard. I'm just using my regular old brush that I got from my, one of my Urban Decay palettes. For packing on powder, it's really not. You don't need anything insane. And my suggestion to anyone and everyone who I talk to about makeup, or is new to makeup, or whatever, if you're gonna splurge for anything, splurge for brushes. The best, you know, with whatever you're limited to price point. I mean, you can get really good brushes for really inexpensive. I'm going to try this again. This froze up on me pretty bad. I don't even remember what eyeshadow I was even putting on. And actually, can we all have a sad moment? My one-year-old loves makeup. Loves it. Loves to get into it. I stepped away to put my six-year-old on a timeout. It just happened. Anyhow, I was using nougat with my, I kind of want to cry. With my Urban Decay, P.S. Represent Girl Green Bay. We're coming this year for the Vince Lombardi Trophy. Anyhow, blah, 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 blah. Nougat with my Urban Decay brush. Just packing it on. Really, I'm really, really into mattes lately. You can go bold with them, it seems like, without looking like a shimmer fest and like you're going out to the club. Then I'm winging this whole thing. I'm gonna take one of my. I don't know what I'm gonna take actually. I'm gonna take my Wayne Goss number 4 brush. But I can't. I'm gonna go into Actually, it's a really cute little quad from Ulta. Ulta's makeup really isn't that bad. It's cheap and people think it's bad, but it's not. And I'm going to take the color Organza, this purpley shade right here, and work that about halfway through my crease. The best way to do this, find your crease and go like this. Does the work for you, and don't push too hard. But I can't go really deep. If I go too deep and if I go too dark, I'm going to blend a darker color. My deep-set eyes look like my eyeballs are sunken into my skull. I'm happy with that. And then I'm going to take... my newly sad palette, Licorice, the black right here. I'm going to use a small brush for this just to apply because I want control. And I'm going to do this in my mirror. So I hope, why don't I go like this? Because I, you know, for years and years have just watched and watched and watched and watched to get an education on this. And I guess it really doesn't serve a purpose if I'm not showing you what I'm doing. Rig up a little mirror here. Oh! No, I'm not gonna do that. I found it. This is my wedding. This is what I wore at my wedding. I love green, and green was my color. It's Mildew by Urban Decay. How are we gonna work that? I'm gonna layer. I'm gonna take, I'm going to take, fix my nose ring. I'm going to take Licorice, and I'll pull up my eyelid so you can see. But I'm not coming all the way over because I'm going to be blending. Clean off my, I'm going to use smaller brush because I don't want to mess. If you use a huge brush, you know, especially if you have small eyes, you know, don't use a huge brush if you have small eyes, or it's this, you know, this is workable for my eye shape. As are these, but these I use very light-handedly. First drive the nut. I'm gonna use this mirror for this. Can you see? Okay. And bring it up. And then I'm gonna pull my eyelid taut. But yeah, you don't want to use a dirty brush to blend because you're not applying product, you're blending it. Same on this buddy. I could honestly use a bigger brush for this, but I really like to have control over what I'm doing. I've struggled for years with eyeshadow, and that's still not what I want. A little bit more into my corners. And then I'm going to take a bigger brush. And people blend circular. I go horizontal and bring it in. I'm going to be bringing this up. I'll be able to see it better on the other. that's what I want. Okay, I'm happy with that. One of my eyes is way puffier than the other one today. I don't know why. Then I'm going to take my wedding shade. I haven't yanked it out since my wedding, so I kind of want to. And I think purples and greens, I have green eyes. Purples and greens are great on green eyes. Yes, should.
You look pretty without
makeup. Thanks, babes. I did not tell her to say that, but that's really sweet. I'm going to layer this green mildew shade on top of the black.
Addie's doing some chores. She's cleaning out the toilet.
Oh, God.
The toilet.
All right, Addie, that's good on that. And then I'm going to take that purple from that quad. Sheer out a little bit more of the transition. Oh, I love this. I love it when you have a good makeup day or you're just like unsure of what to do and then it just ties together and winds up looking good. And I feel like I need a little bit better of a merriment of this green. I'm happy with that. And then for a highlight, I'm going to take Strange from this one. And let me do a quick swatches of what I've done. These are all trying to do this so you can actually see it. These are all the colors I used. I don't know what that is. It's probably getting shit off my brush. So I'm going to take Strange, very subtle highlight. Okay. This is so hard to do. And then kind of blend them together just a little bit. Nothing crazy. Because you don't want to take away all that work you just did, but you don't want any lines. So you can kind of see what my straight line technique that I was kind of discussing before. You start at your pupil. I'm going to go my pupil. And then you go straight out. And it really is good for deep set, hooded, any of that, because it automatically lifts. And as soon as we do our eye shadow, gosh, this is going for forever. I'm sorry. If you don't want to watch it, don't watch it. Going longer than I had planned to go. I'm going to take this purple shade we used, the Ulta Organza shade, and I'm going to come underneath my lid. And then you want to bring them up. Then you want to bring it up to marry the rest of everything. Naturally just bring it up there. But try to stay in the bounds of what you've already done with your shadow. That makes any sense. And I'm just using an Ulta crease like a pencil brush for this, so I have a little more precision. This is supposed to be a crease brush. This is not a crease brush. Oh, damn it. Okay, cool. Then, I'm actually going to use this as a liner, too. This will probably be able to be really easy. Actually, no, not easily at all. And just chunk it into my lashes. I don't want any line at all. Just thickening my lashes. Then I'm going to take my Bobbi Brown cream caviar shot with the same brush. I like to double line. It just keeps it, I feel like it stays longer. Okay. So I'll show you what I'm doing here in 2 seconds. Wing liner 101. This is not blended out. Mother, should I trust the government? No! Not gonna get into politics! Go at a 45 degree angle. Right from where your eye naturally has a semi-circle thing going. Just go up and then, oh, fuck. Don't want that much of a wing. Go up and then fill in, which I'm gonna do here because I didn't do that well. Then start at the middle of your pupil and go straight out. So 45 and then fill from here to here. When I do a wing is I go back with, you know, like the licorice shade from this little puppy, and I'll add it in to kind of give me a little bit more forgiveness with the perfection of it. And it makes it a little more smoky, and that brush is too big. That just way messed it up. Okay, I'm happy with that. But I'm going to take my strange. Need a better blend on that. The eyelash is an old curl here. There, got him. Pulse. I'm not gonna make a big thing of it just because this is going on for like an hour and I'm gonna have to like edit it out big time or something. Best way. Okay. Good. Okay. Sorry this is taking me so fucking long. Then I'm going to take my favorite blush ever. Actually, this is a pink blush look. This is a... I want pink on this. So I'm going to take my Park Avenue Princess palette. I don't know what color the blush is, but it's really pretty. My e.l.f. brush, and I'm going to kind of squish it. And then pinch your brushy. This is so hard to do on. I'm going to use my mirror over here. And like I said earlier, be light-handed because you've done all this work with your foundation already. And this is just the method that works for my face. I've got a very oval face. If you have an oval face, put your blush on from here and here. If you have like a really round face, you know, or a heart-shaped face, you can go just in the apples. But don't go like this because if you look, these go up. So go a little bit above that. And then lips. I guess lippy. Cider. For a nice like nude. And that's kind of it, I think. Oh, and then usually I use my... This is going on so fucking long. Usually I use my powder puff for this, but I'm just going to take my powder brush, dap it off. Cheech and Chong in here. And then just not even really applying any pressure whatsoever. Alright guys, and that is my like 8-hour video on how to do my makeup today. Love y'all! See you later! Sometime soon. Bye.